to Flight Test. I'm Josh, and this is Josh.
Hi.
Now, one thing that we cannot say enough about at Flight Test is our amazing community. There are some incredible people from all over the world that contribute to everything that Flight Test does.
Incredible talents, too. They have over 5,500 articles and, what is it, 20,000?
20,000 different forum threads on our website. Just all people from the community helping each other out, all kinds of new ideas. It's great.
So what we wanted to do is we wanted to showcase 5 of those just to let you guys know what amazing things that these people bring to the table.
One cool article from Randy St. Clair talked about his VTOL Explorer. I guess he actually took an FT Explorer.
Yes.
And made a VTOL.
So, I really haven't even touched the sticks, hardly. We got a little bit of wind this morning, 2 or 3 miles an hour. So I'm going to go ahead and switch into slow forward flight mode. And you'll notice the forward thrust motor just started running. Now it's running slowly, but I'm only managing 1 throttle stick, not 2. So let's go ahead and do a transition into full forward flight. Now I'm just going to flip the switch and let it do it all by itself here. I am hands off the sticks right now. I have not touched the stick the entire time. It is flying by itself. And now I'm going to take over because I need to turn it eventually. But that's all I'm doing is just turning.
And one thing that makes a really good article is not only did he have a great video, great write-up on how to do it, but he had parts lists. He had details about how to do it. Everything that you would struggle with to accomplish that, which is pretty complicated, he went ahead and addressed and did a great article about that.
Thanks, Randy.
Yes.
He used to be in Run DMC, but not more, so he's Randy.
MC?
MC, yeah. I think he's still an MC, though. Now, Kevin Matusik wrote a great article about the Raiden. It's a forward swept pusher with canards. This thing looks like a space dragon.
What do you design?
Kevin Matusik.
And this is the Raiden? And this is the Raiden. This is the big Raiden, right?
Yeah.
And a smaller version of yourself and a smaller version of your design. Who's this?
Colin.
Colin?
Kevin, sorry.
And this is your mini Raiden, right?
Yes.
You guys gotta see this fly. You gonna fly for us?
Yeah,
awesome.
He's taking this thing through so many different renditions, from small size to big size. Matter of fact, we even got to fly it with him at NEF last year.
Cool.
And it flew amazing. Him and his son were flying it around. His son had a small version. We flew the bigger version. It's an incredible platform for FPV or just cruising around. Kevin not only made an amazing article, but he also made incredible plans that people could follow along with lots of build videos and build details to make sure people could do it. Also, this is available in different size formats, FPV modules. I think he even has an EDF version out now. And he really took the extra mile to make sure people could repeat this experience and have a lot of fun flying it. And it flies great.
Nice, thanks, Kevin. Now, Jack started a thread on our forum called Flight Test Fan or Fanatic, Help Me. And he does need help. He really does.
I love the part, even down as we, it warmed our heart, but as we read down through the post, even the intervention that his wife had with him to kind of be like, okay, now it's taken to another level, because he's retired and he builds a lot of airplanes. He follows along with our reviews and our builds, and he follows, you know, through with that.
His wife must love him very much, because we saw the picture of his storage system. It looks like it's in their living room.
The storage system is amazing.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Yeah. Now, what's even more special about how much he loves the hobby is how much he loves sharing the hobby. Mm-hmm. And that's really what warmed our heart.
Yeah, he actually took it all to the next level. Instead of just keeping all these planes for himself, he's actually spreading them out and allowing other people to get into the hobby.
He even goes as far when he can find bulk buys, like on Amazon with multi-rotors. If there's a neighbor kid that's into the hobby, he gives them a quad, gives them the ability to start the hobby, and helps them learn how to fly it. And hats off to him. And that's exactly what we want to see our community doing, and you're doing a great job.
Thanks, Jack. Now, Todd Merrill wrote a really cool article about his version of the bushwhacker, which he calls the weed whacker.
Yeah, and a beautiful thing about that is one thing we like to see is when people take an FT design and they dream bigger.
Yeah.
And they take what they learn, they take different components from different planes. It's a beautiful example of what he did with this, but also he shared the whole evolution of what he learned.
The whole article is based on what he learned, the failures, the mistakes, and all the different evolutions every step to get him to his end goal.
And even when he had problems, he reached out to other community members and he brought in their solutions. So it's a beautiful, well-rounded article. He did something great with LED lights.
Yeah, the LEDs look sweet. He did a really good job with that.
Yeah, and you guys can take that knowledge and apply it to other FT builds and have the same experience.
Thanks, Todd. Now, a good friend of ours, Dan Sponholz, or known on the articles as Spons, he wrote a really cool article about printing off plans.
Yes. Now, Dan Sponholz, if you guys have ever downloaded any of our free plans that go along with our FT designs, you're going to notice they have legends, keys, details about F-packs, all the details on there. Dan does that, but he wants to take it an extra level and make sure when people print this out, they have a good experience too.
Right.
So this article is all on how to print out free plans. And it may sound like something very simple, but there's a lot of details you got to know to make sure it's scaled right and things like that. Dan really went the extra mile to make sure it's clear, easy to understand, and you can also apply what he did and take it to other people's plans as well.
Thank you, Dan.
Hey.
Now that's just five really great articles and forum threads out of thousands on the website. The community has really shown us a lot of great stuff.
The best part about flight tests is not the shows, it's the community. And we really want you guys, if you haven't gotten an opportunity to meet them, to do so. Especially if you're getting in the hobby, have questions, the forums are a really great place to go.
Please contribute to the articles and on the forums. Flighttest.com actually just got a facelift, so it's actually a lot easier to navigate. It's pretty cool.
Check it out, and we'll see you next time.
See you next time.